Module-based planning provides complete planning and budgeting solutions for financials, workforce, capital, projects, and strategic modeling with built-in, best practice, predefined content, including forms, calculations, dashboards, drivers, and key performance indicators. With capital, you plan for the long-term impact of capital assets on financial plans. And you can manage, prioritize, and plan for capital investments and expenses. In planning, navigate to the Configure page. On the Configure page, you can enable strategic modeling, financials, workforce, capital, and projects. I'll configure capital. In Enable Features, you select which predefined drivers, categories, and options you want to use. New Capital Investment allows you to plan, prioritize, and request for tangible, leased, and intangible assets while planning for funding, cash flow impact, and asset-related expenses. For leased assets, you can select IFRS 16 Standard, which will calculate the lease based on IFRS 16 standards. You can select to add named assets to plan at a detailed level and specify the likely number of named assets for a planning cycle. Manage existing assets allows you to plan the life cycle of existing assets, including retirements, transfers, and improvements of both tangible and intangible assets, and plan for asset-related expenses, such as repairs, maintenance, and insurance. Optionally, you can map existing dimensions to capital dimensions, rename base dimensions, and add custom dimensions in this section. I'll enable new capital investments for tangible and leased assets. Next, I'll add custom dimensions. I'll select project as a custom dimension so that I can integrate capital projects with the projects module. I'll also select vendor and funding source. After reviewing your selections, you can proceed with the enable process. This process takes a moment to complete. When the status displays that capital was enabled successfully, log off and log back on to see your changes. From the home page, you can now access new investments under capital. Let's go back to the configure page for capital. Configurable content for capital was enabled. You can configure drivers, load metadata, and exchange rates required by your organization. From the Actions menu, you can review modified artifacts and refresh the database. If you need to add more features, you can do so on the Enable Features page. I'll enable additional features for new capital investment and manage existing assets. When the process completes, log off and log back on once more to see your changes. Notice that you can now access both new investments and manage existing assets from the home page. Next, I'll configure some of the content enabled for capital. Tangible and intangible assets are grouped by asset class, which contains the same characterizations, depreciation methods, and other assumptions. Asset class members may be selected from a predefined set shipped out of the box, added manually, or imported. I'll add the predefined asset class, office equipment. Next, I'll add a new asset class. The natural resources asset class will be used by assets such as natural gas and timber oil. Refresh the database after you make metadata changes. Make sure to complete all required areas in the configuration. We are now ready to plan for capital. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.